Very good afternoon, students. So this is our new chapter, individual and group presentation. Actually, this is the course extension 231, communication skills and personality development. Getting? So regarding the personality development, we have seen definition, characteristics, then factors affecting personality. Then we can say determinants of personality or the characteristics of personality that we have seen. And regarding the communication part, actually we have seen the communication and as our title is communication skills. No, so communication we have seen, but regarding the skill part of the communication, that actually we are going to look or the discuss now. So out of the different skills, it might be a listening, it might be a speaking skills, it might be a writing skill, whatever. Out of these skills, the first or the one thing is there, how we are expressing, getting? Actually, communication is nothing but expressing yourself. But as you're talking to with your friend or the group of friends, that is the different type of communication. And while the communication in the seminar, in the conferences are the different one. Getting? That means better to say a professional communication. Getting? It's a professional communication. And in that professional communication, you must have a good listening, you must have a good writing and speaking skills. Okay, so this individual and group presentation is a part of speaking skills. Getting? So how you are speaking in the organization or in the seminar and conferences. And for that sake, for better speaking, you must have a good idea about the subject matter and the idea about how to present. Getting? How to present. Actually, I told you in the communication that you should have such a skill that you should present, you should not present the idea, but you should present the story. Getting? As people always like to listen the story, so you must have such a skill that you should bind your message into a story in the chronological in the chronology, and then should present. Getting? So presentation part that we are going to learn today, two types are there, individual and group presentation. But before prior to that, what is exactly the presentation is? Actually, the name or this term itself explaining presentation, how to present yourself. So presentation means how the message is communicated or placed before the audience. That means which way you are using to present yourself or the expressing yourself, that is actually presentation in. So the presentation may be individual or the group of experts. So very first is the individual presentation. So individual presentation, actually both pros and cons are there of the each presentation, either it's an individual or it's a group presentation. But let's have one by one. So what individual presentation gives us? So it gives us an opportunity of speaking in front of a group. Firstly, it is opportunity. Then second, talk should cover a topic that interests you and that is relevant to the audience. When your presentation will be effective, when you are empathizing. Actually, why do you like to watch the movies? As someone a diehard fan of the Salman, Shah Rukh, Ajay Devgan, Akshay Kumar, we love them or and love their movie also. But as usual, we always like to, actually for me particularly, I love movies. Getting? But why actually I like these movies? Because of the topic they choose for the movie, it is of my interest. It is of my interest. So whatever the presentation, whenever you are presenting yourself, your talk or your matter, subject matter should be of interesting for you. Getting? And second thing, from the audience point of view, it should be relevant. So people can hear you. Okay. So ideas or topics may be taken from newspaper, articles, magazines, technical journal, book, or from your own personal experiences. Whatever topic, doesn't matter, whatever. It should be of your own interest, nothing else. And group presentation provides a tremendous opportunities to create something much greater than an individual can normally do. Actually, any individual, yes, he might be jack of all, but master of none. Getting? But if you have to prepare an excellent presentation, then you must needed some help from the rest of people. So definitely, if opportunity or the group presentation definitely will have the impact, because the different brains are working over there. Getting? So it is always easier and quicker to do the things on your own. Actually, you are your own boss. So as you, your mindset is prepared, definitely you can go for this. But regarding the effective part, definitely group presentation will be the, will have the different impact actually. So how to create the group presentation? First thing, actually, we should have some common understanding about the group presentation. First thing, team and group, definitely there is a difference. Getting? Team of India and group of people. What is, I'm telling you, team of India and group of people. So team of India is having us just a single agenda that we have to win. But in the group, there might be a different agendas. Getting? Actually, group is a more sound actually, because whenever we are talking about the group, they must have their own, they must have the unique goal. But in practical life, it doesn't. Getting? So in the group presentation, we always remember it's a team presentation. Then line up. Who is the expertise? In which area? We should have a thorough understanding, thorough knowledge, and according to his strength or her strength, we should allot that task. Getting? Then it's one presentation. That means we should not, what we can say, we should not impress individually, but our presentation should impress the people. So we should come up as a team. Then execution of the plan, as per the plan actually. Then toward the effective group presentation, that the ultimate goal is effective group presentation. So advantages, team presentation. Variety is built right into the presentation by virtue of having different people presenting. Different people are presenting with their specialization. So definitely. And if you are in a team, then what will be there? That one can manage audio visual, or other can concentrate on talking. If something mishappens, then the third person can manage it well. So that is actually the benefit of the team presentation. Then greater expertise can be available through the formation of a group. Then presentation task, timing, linked with questions can be managed better. Getting? By the team presentation. Then building your lineup. One of the reason to identify the strength and weakness of each member in the presentation group. If anybody from your group is having excellent stage daring, then he should start. He should create the enthusiasm in the group or in the meeting hall. So if you have such a lineup, then definitely it will help in success of presentation. Then one presentation, that means the style of presentation. Getting? That the, what you can say, the tone of the presentation should be the unique one, and this should be the single one. Then execution, The day of presentation, you will not regret one moment of preparation and rehearsal. You don't have any right to tell you in this way. So proper execution. Then towards effective group presentation. So what are the points actually? Care should be taken to arrange the requirement. Then recognize the group presentation is a team, and that will take the time to build. That means we should create such an enthusiastic environment amongst the group member that everyone feel free to express the ideas, and everyone should feel that this is mine, or the it's not a group, but the presentation is of mine. So that will create the excellency in the presentation. Regarding the oral presentation, it provides an opportunity for give and take decisions. We generally lead to better understanding of the finding and their implication. Oral presentation. Ready? That means if the oral presentation is going on, it will create the live scenario or the live scene. Okay. Usually it is most famous or the popular in the academic institutions, where researcher discusses his findings and policy application in a seminar or in a group discussion. These are the some actually features of oral presentation. How should create the effective oral presentation? Getting? So what thing you should possess or the you should use during the oral presentation, that it might be a gesture, it might be a transition signal, a review, preview of the presentation, then call to action, that means appearing, then a rapport, then handing over to the audience, then involvement of the audience, personal anecdote, and highlighting. Okay, then clarifying the issues, then you should get personalized with the people, then at last, while the conclusion session or while ending your session, so that time how your behavior should be. Getting? So these are some examples I can say. Gesture, that means what kind of your positive gesture should be there. Ready? That means if somebody is asking some questions, then you should not first thing regret. Second thing, you should not get angry. How you dare to ask me question? Such kind of. So you must always maintain the positive gesture. Getting? Then transition signal. That means your style of sitting, of walking. That is again. So these are the actually signals. Just 2 days back, you might be watching some news and reading the newspaper. So I think one of the cricketer, I think he is captain of Pakistan team. Okay. So it was about his absence in the ground, on the ground. Getting? So it gives or it passes the signal actually. So you should have a positive, you should deliver the positive signals. Then the review. The people, then preview the people or the preview the presentation, then call to action. That means as we are moving to the other area, so that time you should use such features or the such a of what you can say actually features. Then rapport should have a positive rapport. Then handing over, that means regarding the cause. Effects, then audience involvement, you should involve the audience, then personal anecdote, that means you should have the personal touch, that means with their life. Getting? Then highlighting, if some things or some points are very important, then you should highlight by repeating it or by giving a stress on that words. Then clarifying. You should give the clarification of some statistics, then personalization regarding, and at last I am telling you the ends or the question regarding questions. Okay. Actually, for today, I think it is more than enough regarding the presentation and evaluation part. Actually, we'll take it because we don't know what will be your question paper. Why I'm telling you, because since last 2-3 years, every year in the semester examination, discrepancies are occurring. Okay, so I think we should have access. Getting? So in the next lecture, we will start with that evaluation part. Okay, so thank you.